things that I often hear, one of the criticisms I hear, is that I'm a Luddite. Well, I want to prove to you today that I'm not a Luddite. I'm actually wearing Google glasses, and I'm going to use it to talk a little bit about that first moment when you see a patient. I've always felt that that first moment, whether it's standing outside a clinic door and there's a clinic chart there, and you don't know who you're going to meet, you don't know how the story is going to unfold, and especially in the early days of HIV, it was a very poignant moment. That person I was seeing was a new patient who would probably be with me till the end, which the end was very near in those days because we didn't really have any of the drugs we had today. But even today, I think there's always a certain poignancy to that first moment when you're meeting a stranger, but you're not meeting them as a stranger, you're meeting them as a physician, and they're in a very vulnerable position. It's a very important and delicate moment. And I always think that when I actually begin the exam, when the patient has entrusted me with the willingness to disrobe and allow me to examine them, there's a way to enter into this, and I always choose to enter into it beginning with the hand. So I'm here with my colleague John Kugler, who's very kindly consented to be the patient today, and I want to illustrate this moment of finishing the history and beginning the actual examination of the patient. And I always think that a nice way to enter that moment is with the hand, rather than reaching straight for their chest or their neck, which could be quite intimidating. It's a natural gesture to extend my hand, they extend their hand out, and in that gesture, which is very much like shaking the hand, I slide my right hand further down and my left hand begins to examine the pulse. And I'm registering things like rate, rhythm, volume. And interestingly, I think most of the time, the patient also is aware that you're feeling their pulse. So there's this moment of connection there. And meanwhile, my right hand is checking things like the warmth of the hand. Are they very vasoconstricted or are they very warm? Is the hand sweaty? And things like thyrotoxicosis, or is it dry? And when I'm done with the pulse, I'm also looking for clubbing. I'm looking for cyanosis against the white backdrop of my coat. I flip the hand over, and I'm looking for palmar erythema, which is islands of redness over an otherwise fairly pale palm, feeling for Dupuytren's contracture. And when I'm done with that, it seems it's very natural then to extend my hand up to the epitrochlear node, and I am now in my ritual. William Osler said many years ago, patients will judge you not by the diplomas on your wall or by the certificates in your office, but by the manner and ease with which you do the least maneuver. And I think beginning the exam is a great place to start.
The preceding program is copyrighted by the Board of Trustees of the Leland Stanford Junior University. Please visit us at med.stanford.edu.